If you're really good at math, you no doubt did the calculation all in your head and got the correct answer. But if you're a regular person, you probably need a calculator or at least a pen and a piece of paper. Fortunately, there's an easy hack to do this without writing anything down. The trick is to visualize the fraction as the slope of a right triangle. In case of the first fraction on the left, think of the denominator as the length of the right triangle and the numerator as its height. Do the same for the second fraction on the right, and then your job is to simply compare the two slopes and see which is steeper, since the steeper the slope, the bigger the fraction. But wait, you might say, how is this helpful, since it's not possible for you to tell which slope is steeper without doing the exact same calculations we're trying to avoid? Well, you will have to make some adjustments to the second fraction first, like so. Does that help? If you need a minute, stop this video, because the next set of explanations come in 3, 2, 1. If you don't get it yet, that's because you now have to visualize the second fraction as two right triangles joined at their tips rather than one. First, draw a triangle that has the length of 215 with a height of 43. This triangle is obviously the same as the one on the left, but we're not done yet. We still need to add an additional length of 20 and an additional height of 10. That will be our second triangle. Now, if you draw a line from the start of the first triangle to the end of the second, you now have the slope of the right triangle created from the second fraction. A right triangle which has a length of 235 and a height of 53. And lo and behold, you can easily see that the slope of the triangle created from the second fraction is in fact steeper than the first one. Subsequently, the second fraction 53 over 235 is bigger than the first fraction 43 over 215. In case you're bad at drawing, all you have to do is notice that 1 over 2 is obviously much bigger than 43 over 215. And because of this, we know that the slope of the second triangle we drew has a steeper slope than the one created by the first fraction. As a result, when you combine the two triangles, the end result must be a triangle with a steeper slope than the one created by the first fraction. On the other hand, if the slope of the second triangle is less than the slope of the triangle created by the first fraction, then the second fraction would be the smaller of the two. You can think of it as adding vectors if you're familiar with them. If not, go check out our video on vectors and vector sums. And if you didn't know already, that's how you compare complicated fractions without a pen and a piece of paper. Sticks and stones. Thank you for watching. Hit the like button if you got the correct answer, and subscribe if you haven't already.